Dominic College of Asia. We, the BSN3B RLA Group 1, will present about balanced skeletal traction. Let us define traction. Traction is the act of pulling or drawing an opposite direction, which is always associated with counter traction.
In this video demonstration, we are going to use two types of traction, the manual traction and the skeletal traction. Manual traction is a pulling force applied by the hands of the operator. Skeletal traction is a pulling force applied directly to the bone using wires, pins, and tongs.
We are going to present balanced skeletal traction and have indications for this.
First, reduce fracture. Second, for immobilization. Third, for support. Fourth, to reduce pain and muscle spasm. Fifth, to maintain good alignment. And the last one is to prevent and correct deformity. Now, let's go to preparation. First, check the doctor's order. When you're checking the doctor's order, make sure to clarify the patient's name and check the extremity to be applied on BSD and also check the weights to be applied.
Second is, prepare the patient psychologically. First is, introduce yourself. Second, patient, inform the patient of what is to be done. Third is, explain to the patient the purpose and procedure. And the last is, the expectations from the patient.
And for the third preparation, you should prepare the bed and the equipment needed.
So these are the equipments. First is, patient must be in dorsal recumbent position. Second, there must be a counter traction. Patient weight will be the counter traction. And third is, there must always be continuous traction.
The next is, the line of pulley should be in line with the deformity. The first pulley should be in line in the inguinal area. The second pulley should be in line with the knee. And the third pulley should be in line with the first and second pulley. And the last one is to avoid friction. In order to avoid friction, there should be no knots along the pulley. Cord should be running along the grooves of the pulley. The next is weights. The weight should be hanging freely. And the last one is observe for the wear and tear of the bags and cords.
Should set up the equipment on the same side of the affected area. Then next, measure the distance from the lateral side of the greater trochanter to the knee by using the tie rope. Then, position the Pearson's attachment under the Thomas plate according to the above measurement. And then screw them together. Apply the rest plate. After applying the rest plate, apply the slings. There are different principles of applying the slings. First is the broader and the longer sling should be in the thigh area, and the narrower and the shorter sling should be in the leg area. Then next, start from the medial aspect of the Thomas plate, then pass it to the lateral, to prevent injury. Then apply the sling snugly. If you apply the slings too tight, it will impede the circulation. Then if you apply the slings too loose, it will defeat the purpose of support. And then next is the smooth area of the sling should come in contact with the skin of the patient. This will prevent skin irritation.
If the slings are too long, you should fan fold it.
The number of slings will vary on the size of the patient's leg. So in this case, we use 5 slings because the leg of the patient is too long.
Keep the popliteal part and the outer part free from slings because it will defeat the circulation because it is a vascular area.
On applying slings, you should keep an inch between the slings because it will provide ventilation. Using the slings, tie one end of the tie rope to the medial aspect of the Thomas sling. This is done before the patient's leg insertion to provide privacy. Then consume first.
After applying the slings, we will now going to do the 3-man power. After applying the slings, we will now decide on the 3-man power. The 1-man power will support the leg with the palm of his hand. The 2-man power will provide the continuous manual traction and remove the blunt baller's spleen to the work area. The 3-man power will insert the thumb spleen and the personal attachment to the affected leg. Before doing that, we will instruct the patient to hold on the overhead trapeze, flex the unaffected leg, and lift the bottom. At the count of 3, swing the body so that we can simultaneously transfer the affected leg on the Thomas spleen. 1, 2, 3. On applying balanced skeletal traction, we only have 3 ropes. The longest one is the suspension rope, the longer one is the traction rope, and the short one is the thigh rope, which is attached on the Thomas spleen.
Using a slip knot, tie one end of the traction cord at the stayman spleen holder. Then pass the cord through the groove of the 3rd pulley. Then attach the traction weight bag. The traction weight bag should be 10% of the patient's body weight.
The traction weight bag should be at the level of the bed.
Thank you. then you should consume the remaining loops.
Tie the other end of the tie cord to the lateral aspect of the Thomas pin using a slip knot. Using again a slip knot, tie the other end of the suspension cord to the middle of the tie cord. Pass the suspension cord through the hole to the first pin, then to the suspension weight bag. The suspension weight bag should be one half of the traction weight bag. Temporarily hang the suspension weight bag over the pulley.
Then pass the same cord along the groove of the second pulley, down to the outer side of the traction cord. Under the
Slightly lift the spleen while attaching the rope to the spleen
under the rest pin. Then tie it over the end of the Thomas pin using a club hitch knot. And another club hitch knot. At the end of the person's attachment. And consume the rope. Then release the suspension weight and remove the rest pin. Apply foot pedal using a ribbon cut. The shorter cords should be tied at the Thomas pin. While the longer cords should be tied on the person's attachment. In between the last and second to the last sleeves.
Check for the efficiency of the traction, instruct the patient to hold on to the overhead trapeze, slightly lift the buttocks, and then swing from backwards, forwards, and sideways.
For the removal of the traction, you should always remember that the last thing you've applied should be the first thing you should remove. First, apply the rest splint. Second, hang suspension weight on the first pulley. Third, complete removal of suspension weight. Remove the knot on the person and Thomas splint. Thank you. Fourth, manual traction sustainment pin holder. Remove the traction weight of the third pulley. And fifth, secure the traction rope on the rest plinth, another on the Thomas and Pearson attachment. And then consume the remaining rope.
We also have to remember the nursing care of patients with traction. First is the provision of hygiene and comfort.
Like hair shampoo, sponge bath, perineal care, oral care, and nail care.
Second is avoiding friction.
To avoid infection, we should always observe insertion site, proper cleaning of site, and proper hand washing.
Third is proper nutrition.
You should always make sure that your patient is taking calcium for bone repair, protein for tissue repair, roughage for elimination, vitamin C for resistant and wound healing, vitamin K, vitamin D, and iron.
Fourth is preventing bed sores.
To prevent pressure sores, you should always make sure that the linens are wrinkle-free, keep skin dry, massage bony prominences, swinging with the use of the overhead trapeze.
Fifth is exercise of the unaffected and affected extremity.
The exercise for unaffected extremity is ROM extremity, and the exercise for affected extremity is the quadriceps seating exercise.
The sixth is prevention of pulmonary complications.
Prevent pulmonary complications, instruct the patient to do deep breathing, coughing exercise, and to increase oral fluid intake.
Seventh is diversional activities. And the last one is tending to patient's complaint. That's all.
Thank you.
Clothes like I didn't care. Hopped into a cab, take me anywhere.